Measurement of Angles, Level 3. In this video, we will go over parts of a degree and congruent angles. Let's start with parts of a degree. In surveying, navigation, and other applications of angle measure, we often have to measure angles more precisely than to the nearest degree. We may have to measure angles to the nearest tenth, hundredth, or thousandth of a degree. We can denote fractional parts of an angle in two ways, by using the minutes and seconds notation, or by using decimals. In the minutes and seconds notation, a degree is divided into 60 minutes. For even finer measurements, the minute can be divided into 60 seconds. This last unit is very small, and it is usually used for astronomical measurements and measuring latitude and longitude. Now, a word of caution. These minutes and seconds have nothing to do with time. They represent smaller and smaller parts of a degree. In the context of geometry, degrees, minutes, and seconds refer to angle measurements and not units of time. We denote minutes by a single tick mark or small dash after the number. For example, 30 minutes is written as follows. Seconds are denoted by using a double tick mark or two small dashes after the number. For example, 45 seconds is written as follows. The following angle measure would be pronounced as 67 degrees, 21 minutes, 37 seconds. When minutes and seconds are used alone, we usually say arc minutes and arc seconds to avoid confusion with units of time. A second way of denoting a fractional part of an angle is by using the degree measure plus a decimal fraction of a degree. Similar to the way we measure time, where each hour of the day is divided into 60 minutes, when we say half an hour, we are referring to 30 time minutes. So when we say half a degree, we are referring to 30 arc minutes. For example, an angle that measures 2.5 degrees can be expressed as 2 degrees 30 minutes, since 30 minutes represents half a degree. Likewise, an angle that measures 2.25 degrees would be expressed as 2 degrees 15 minutes, since 15 minutes represents a quarter of a degree. In general, to convert an angle measure with a decimal, we simply multiply the decimal by 60. To obtain a number representing the minutes of a degree. If the minutes happen to also have decimals after multiplying by 60, then we take the decimals of the minutes and multiply them again by 60 to obtain a number representing the seconds. For example, the angle measure 2.135 degrees can be changed into the degree minute second notation by taking the decimal part of the degree, in this case 0.135, and multiplying it by 60, obtaining the number 8.1. This number represents the number of minutes. Notice that this number has the decimal 0.1, meaning that we have 0.1 of a minute, so we take this decimal and multiply it by 60 to convert it into seconds. Doing that, we obtain 6 seconds. So 2.135 degrees can be written as 2 degrees, 8 minutes, 6 seconds. At times, you might want to convert an angle measure written in minutes and seconds into a degree measure with a decimal. To convert the angle, we simply add the degree with a fractional representation of the minutes and seconds. For example, to convert this same angle written in minutes and seconds back to degrees with a decimal, we first convert the minutes into an equivalent degree measure by taking 8 minutes and dividing it by 60, since 1 degree measures 60 minutes. This way, we convert 8 minutes into an equivalent degree measure. We also need to convert the seconds into an equivalent degree measurement. Now, we need to be careful here. We know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. But, since we want to convert seconds into degrees, we need to figure out how many seconds are there in 1 degree. Since 1 minute equals 60 seconds, and 1 degree equals 60 minutes, Then, 1 degree equals 60 times 60 seconds, or in this case, 3,600 seconds. So we convert the seconds into an equivalent degree measure by taking 6 and dividing it by 3,600. Now it is just a matter of adding the degree measure along with these two fractions. We can use a calculator to approximate the fractions and add them to 2 degrees. Doing that, we obtain 2.135. Alright, and this is how you deal with parts of a degree. Let's end the video by going over congruent angles. Congruent angles are angles that have the same measure. In the following diagram, the measure of angle ABC equals the measure of angle DEF. We can write angle ABC is congruent to angle DEF. Notice that when we are referring to the actual measurement of the angle, we use an equal sign. And when we are referring to the figures, we use the congruent symbol. The definition of congruent angles tells us that these two statements are equivalent, and we can use them interchangeably. Just like tick marks are used to show that two line segments are congruent, we use one or more small arc marks to show that two angles are congruent. For example, in the figure shown, triangle CAT and triangle DOG have various arc marks. In this case, angle C and angle D have matching single arc marks, so these angles are congruent. In the same manner, angle A and angle O have matching double arc marks, so these angles are congruent. Lastly, angle T and angle G have matching triple arc marks, so these angles are congruent. Alright, and these are the basics of measuring angles. We can find the measure of an angle by using a protractor, and the measure of an angle is found by computing the absolute value of the difference of the degree measurement that the rays or segments correspond with on the protractor. We can classify angles by sizes, and the four most common angles are acute, right, obtuse, and straight. When we need to measure an angle more precisely, we can use the degrees, minutes, seconds notation to measure fractional parts of a degree. We can also identify and label congruent angles by using arc marks in a diagram, or by using the congruent symbol, which tells us that two angles have the same measurement. Okay, in our next video, we will go over simple examples that makes use of the concepts learned so far.